Hi, welcome at the Stokvel Academy, and it's lovely to have this opportunity to chat to you again. And as you know that at the Stokvel Academy, you know, we are always searching and looking for ways, information that can empower us as abantu be Stokvel, abantu badi Stokvel, you know. It's just a work in progress, and I'm actually looking forward to actually uncovering more, especially this year in 2021, and hopefully that I'll be able to engage with some of you out there. It's just going to be an exciting year. I'm just excited about it, but also feeling that it is a challenge. We know that Stokvel is not a walkover as lots of people would like to imagine and think. By the way, just don't forget to subscribe and like us on our Facebook, and thank you. Bothers me on a day-to-day basis about the Stokvel movement that I love so dearly is the question, are Stokvels fun driven or are Stokvels business driven? You know, I find that quite fascinating, because yes, from time to time we want to be serious and say we take Stokvel seriously, but when you look around, you check, you know what? I just get that fun vibe about Stokvels more than the business aspect of it. And maybe Stokvels are drivers of the economy. It depends on which side of the fence you are. If you are a Mr. Retailer out there, you're making lots and lots of money out of Stokvels, you are bound to feel that Stokvels, they are driving the economy. Maybe, no. They are not driving the economy. Stokvels are just consumers, in my view. I know that may sound a bit confusing and contradicting. You know, one moment you are these massive consumers, you buy groceries, you save, you do all these things. But what does that translate to in terms of you and your Stokvel? That's what I mean. That's my view. That is my opinion. Are Stokvels real drivers of the economy? Maybe it's a topic that we're gonna have to look into and analyze deeply. That takes me back to one of my favorite countries in Africa. It's Tanzania and Kenya, where the Stokvel movement is buzzing, it's vibrant, it's happening. And just to actually prove a point, if you were to actually Google the following words, successful charmers in Kenya, you wait and see what is going to pop up. You're going to get a lot of information about these charmers, their history, what is happening, even specific names. But do the same thing. Just Google successful Stokvels in South Africa and see what is going to pop up. And guys, this is my hobby. I do this from time to time. And sometimes I get angry, I become frustrated and say, what the hell is happening? Or it's not happening in South Africa. You know, of course, I am in no way implying that the Stokvel movement is not a big thing in South Africa. The point I'm making here is that are Stokvels real drivers of our economy? My vision is to actually see the Stokvel agenda being driven within the corridors of the Department of National Department Economic of Development in South Africa. I know some provinces in our country are already doing something in that space. I would also like to see the Stokvel conversation, this Stokvel agenda being part of the Ministry of Finance. Then we will then begin to say Stokvels are one of the main drivers of our economy in South Africa. Thank you. That's my view. That's my opinion.